Songwriter Carol Connors has touched millions of people with her music.
Come bring me your softness. Comfort me through all this madness.
Her eclectic group of friends includes celebrated actors and musicians. She's sung the national anthem for numerous presidents and at prestigious sporting events.
By the dawn's early light.
She's one of the entertainment industry's best loved personalities.
Songwriters Carol Connors.
I'm willing to change my entire life. I don't know anything about legal legality.
Carol Connors' career started young.
I was an incubator baby, and I swear, I think they just wheeled in a little baby grand piano into my little baby incubator and said, start now, because I don't know anything else. I mean, I'm totally audio driven.
At 16, her classmate, the future rock legend Phil Spector, fell in love with her voice. With a loan of $10 from her parents, Carol and Phil formed the band The Teddy Bears and recorded the song To Know Him Is to Love Him. The song shot to number one. When Elvis Presley heard it, he asked to meet the girl who sang it.
And the reason Elvis became my first love was because he wanted to meet the girl who sang To Know Him Is to Love Him. He loved my voice, and I was a girl. So I ended up dating him for 9 months, no baby, but but we dated. And then I went off a cliff in a car, and I didn't have much of a career left. I didn't have much of a face left. I went off Mulholland and Coldwater. Charlton Heston said, drop in, so I did into his backyard. And then I went through periods where things weren't going well, really weren't. And then I wrote a hot rod song called Hey Little Cobra with my brother, which went on to become a number one record. Then I went through a really bad slump again because the Beatles came in. That was the end of United States music, and women were like, all of a sudden, there was a little film about a boxer, and it was $500 up front. This is the house that Rocky bought. I told that to Sly once, he laughed his head off.
Be brave. Carol has gone on to write theme songs for dozens of hit movies.
For each sad little tear. Hold your head up, though no one is near.
Her music has been performed by Placido Domingo, Dionne Warwick, and many other celebrated artists. But Carol has a passion even more consuming than her music. She is a self-confessed ailurophile. She's crazy for kitties.
Pussycat, you're delicious and ill. little pussycat lips. Pussycat, pussycat, I love you. Yes, I do. You and your pussycat lips. Whoa, whoa.
Carol has a particular taste in cats. When she was a teenager, she saw a cat on a houseboat.
And I said to the owner, what is this? What is this animal that is so beautiful? And he said, it's an Abyssinian. And I said, well, what's an Abyssinian? And he said they were the guard cats of the queens of Egypt.
It was so wild and exotic that she vowed that if she ever had money, she would buy such a cat.
Not a Rolls Royce, not a Rolex watch, an Abyssinian cat. And then the day came when I was able to buy my first Abyssinian.
Carol's first two Abyssinians were called Songbird and Harmony. Carol was so in tune with her cats that she had a premonition about Harmony's death.
It was the night before she passed on, and I had this vision, and this voice came to me. I mean, I'm not really a weirdo, I mean, but it really happened. And this voice came to me and said, we have to take Harmony. And I was crying. I said, you can't do that. They said, oh, no, no, no. The voice was very deep. We have to take Harmony. I said, but no, no, I can't live without Harmony. I love Harmony. And the voice said, Harmony has to go visit your father. And my father had passed away. And I was crying really hard at this time in my dream because I could feel it when, you know, what was going on. And I said, okay, okay, okay. If you have to take Harmony, I understand. But I will get another Abyssinian. I said, I will name the kitty cat Maestro. And the voice said that it will be a little boy.
After Harmony died, Carol decided to only have males. Her next two, Minstrel and Maestro, were with her for more than 15 years. Carol had a particularly strong bond with Minstrel. Like her, he embodied star quality.
We even changed his name. He became M the Wonder Cat. And he was wonderful. We did two TV shows together.
How about a gentle round of applause for M the Wonder Cat?
Thank you, thank you. Introducing M the Wonder Cat. We do famous impersonations of famous animals, similar to people doing famous impersonations of famous people. For our first impersonation, we will do Hugh Hefner, a rabbit. And for our final impersonation, we will do bum, 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 Yoda from Star Wars.
Was the most precious animal. He was my favorite of all my kitties. And in the end, when he went blind, he lived an extra year and a half. So I wanted him to feel good about his condition. So I called him M, the Stevie Wonder Cat. And he was priceless. And I miss him.
Carol also had to deal with the tragic demise of Maestro.
People must be careful with cats. Do not leave strings around. He ate the turkey string from the turkey, and it wound around his intestines and killed him. And he died on the same day that my father died, the 24th of December.
Carol has learned to come to terms with the passing of her special friends with the help of poetry.
I would like to read you a poem that was given to me by one of my dear, dear, sweet friends, Lexi Kaufman, when my beautiful Abyssinian, M the Wonder Cat,